Hello, welcome to channel 48. My name is Puck and today I'm gonna show you my Ham International Police Radio Live ATC mod for, of course, the 7500 and the 7510. This afternoon this tablet will be picked up and then, you know, I won't be able to make videos about it anymore. So I modded the ROM from my friend DCatF. Yes, DCatF, I cannot forget his name. It's a very important person because he's the only one, in fact, creating ROMs for this device. All the other developers are sleeping. I don't know what they're doing. They're not doing anything. They're just sitting there and not doing anything for this tablet. Of course, they do a whole lot of work for other devices. So I'm just kidding you out there. But this device only has one developer, and that is Mr. and Master DCatF. Can I have a big applause, please? Well, DCatF, that was your virtual applause, what you got from me and, you know, my complete crew, all my 28,000 subscribers that will probably never see this video, but that's all good. So let's get started and let's go ahead and film the process for you and show you how beautiful, beautiful, beautiful a 7.7 years old tablet can still be in 2019. Tum tum, there we are again. So let's turn on the tablet. The tablet is still on Oreo. I showed you Oreo, right? And yeah, I told you that I would not keep it on Oreo because yeah, the tablet is leaving today and I don't want to set the people up with something that they, you know, they will not know what to do. So let's go ahead and restart the tablet. Now remember, because I'm on Android 8 and because I have Big Sys Twerp installed, I will have to downgrade my Twerp back if I'm gonna install a lower version of Android, and that will be the case. We're gonna go for Android 6. So let's boot into a download mode. So we go back into a download mode, connecting the device. Okay, so at this point, I'm gonna go for Twerp 2.8. If you don't know what is happening now, well, we connected the tablet to a Windows computer that has a tool called Odin installed, and we're flashing Twerp 2.8 by hitting the PDA in Odin and browsing for the Twerp file, you know, and then while being connected to the device in a download mode, it will then flash the Twerp, as you can see. Gonna long press, turn it off. This tablet is so different from the 7510. We turn it on and we hold the volume down. So these are, yeah, in fact this is also an easy way to put it into a download mode or even a recovery mode, but you must know how. If you're gonna press these two buttons or volume up or volume, it's not gonna go. So here we downgrade it back to our old Twerp, so we're gonna wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik get system data. Let's see if we get no red lines. Formatting using catch first. Yeah, okay, this looks good. And we go back and we go back home. We say install and we go again for the Puck Ham International ROM mod. It's effect, it was a mod. And I pushed it into the ROM. Make no mistake, this ROM, even though it looks different, and even though, you know, it got another name, this thing is still AOSP from DCatF. DCatF made this thing, and it would not be there if he would not create it. So let that be said, okay. So DCatF is the man, he's the man behind this beautiful project that is also covering software for a very old tablet. Just think of it, 7 year old tablet. Just look at all the tablets that you still have, the phones and the tablets that you still have from 7 years old. If we talk about 7 years old, we're going back to 2011. What kind of devices did we have at that time? I think the S2, the S3, these are all from this time, I think. I will check it out and see if I can add some devices that were from that time. But you can see that Samsung devices, you can say a whole lot of things about Samsung, you know, but their devices, their Android devices, and as well the Google Nexus devices, these are the best devices, in fact, in the, yeah. Now Huawei is gonna get pissed off with me and all. But hey, Huawei is putting in locked bootloaders, just like in what is their name again? I forgot their name. I also got the phone from my dad from them. All these guys are locking the bootloader. I have no idea why bootloaders are being locked. Probably, yeah. So they can be. You can be hacked easily by some boot virus. I don't know. I think it's the same thing like Windows at a certain moment creating software only for UEFI devices. Well, it's not only for UEFI devices, but the devices they created were in fact only having a UEFI bias. And a UEFI bias is not that friendly to guys that want to install another operating system on the device. You know, by accident I found out about Bootia 32.efi, that it also had to be in the EFI boot folder. That was just by accident I found out, because I could not understand why Gparted and Partition Magic would boot on a Windows 8.1 tablet with a UEFI bias out of the box. And why, you know, Ubuntu 64-bit that was claiming to be UEFI friendly, why it could not? So then I went comparing, and then I saw the secret. I saw that Gparted and Partition Magic had a Bootia 32.efi file in the boot folder of EFI, you know, and the only thing I did, in fact, I grabbed that 32.efi from Gparted and I put it into the folder of the 64-bit boot folder of EFI. You know, the operating system is 64-bit, but if Bootia 32.efi is not available, then these tablets, they won't boot, because in some way they have a 32-bit bias. That is also something crazy that I never understood. The thing is 64-bit, but in fact it needs 32-bit BIOS file. I did not understand that. But these are the things that we find out. And then we overcome these problems, but then we get to the end to a device that is not having no Wi-Fi, is not working, sound is not working, or maybe sound is working, but then touchscreen is not working, or crazy things like that, you know? And Nicola, let me see what Nicola Robinson commented. Congrats on passing, and the Celica looks great as normal. I would not be without my Celica, Fred, and you always get a look. This guy, he understands. Celica is a fantastic, beautiful, nice car. Eh? Daar staat hij weer. Klaar voor een nieuw jaar. So yeah, I was talking about my daily system, and here it is, and I'm enjoying it for more than 3 weeks now, eh? And it's very, very stable. Every day I'm using this thing for many things on the internet, to create ROMs or record music, you know. Even though it's saying Microsoft Longhorn, this is my edition of Linux, Android, you know. Up here we have Wine, we can install Windows applications. Tja. Lovely system. And I don't install to to virtual machines. Eh? I'm not these Linux guys that are in fact Windows users, but then use some virtual, I don't know what. These guys, they are, you know, every day they come live, then they make videos about Linux distributions. You know, and they're talking about how fantastic Linux is and that they created Linux from scratch. But they are on Windows. How I mean, like, what kind of crap is that? I cannot trust any Linux any Linux preacher that is using Windows. You're on Windows, then you're talking about, I mean, like, you know, get out of here, man. This guy called Sudo Reboot. That guy is a joke, man. You know, he's trying to make fun of my, well, not fun, but he was in fact amazed. The guy didn't even know what was Alien. So, and then he's talking about he creating from scratch. From scratch he created some Manjaro thing. That's what he said. So I went checking and I see that, you know, every noob can create some distro, some custom distro, but that's not from scratch. I never say that I create my distros from scratch. I'm not the creator of my distros. We have developers for that. I'm not gonna reinvent the wheel. The wheel is already invented. Now it's a matter of letting the wheel roll. And what, it doesn't matter how you're gonna roll it. You know, in what way you're gonna roll it. If you're gonna create a Winix looking system or a Mac system from your Linux, it doesn't matter. As long as it's running. If it's running, if the wheel is turning, then you have a goal. It doesn't matter how it turns and how it's been turned. As long if it's turning. You know, look here. This is not virtual box like this guy, Sudo Reboot. No, this is a real hardware. You know, I'm not some hypocrite talking about Linux and then I'm scared to install it on real hardware. What kind of crap is that? These people, they have no common sense. They're sitting there and pretending to know a whole lot and pretending to be, you know, some god. That, well, in fact, these guys are on Windows. Windows. Yesterday, I went looking one of his live shows. The thing starts with Windows. And then he opens some virtual box. I don't know what he's doing. He's not on Linux. He's only using Linux in a virtual environment. So that guy, he don't trust Linux developers. Otherwise, he would not be on some virtual thing. Probably he's doing all sorts of other things on the internet he don't want people to know about. That's why he's on virtual system. I'm not on not even one virtual system. I don't use no VPN. I use my real IP address. You know, I'm not like these people. You know, pretending to be some I don't know what. Give me a break, man. Give me a break. Give me a break. At least be on a Linux system when you show Linux videos. At least be on some Linux system and not on VirtualBox in Windows. Get out of here, man. And then you hate on Windows. Hey, look at that! Baby. Oh, look at that. Oh, it's hurting my eyes. I can almost turn these little buttons. Look at that. This is lovely, 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 lovely. I'm so happy with this ROM. So this will then, yeah, I covered Android 8. I covered Android 7.12. And this is Android 6 Marshmallow as well by DKTF. So this ROM, even though it looks like, you know, this, it's by DKTF, it's the same ROM from DKTF, the Android 6, the AOSP, the empty ROM with nothing in it. So I filled it up. I will send this ROM as well to him so he can share it on his XDA. because this is as well from him. This is combination Pukram and Decat F. Or let's say differently, Decat F and Pukram. Yeah, I should be on the second place, you know, because he created the rum. So that must always be the man. So yeah, this guy is, yeah, he's a king here on my channel. Because, yeah, all the three rums work fine. And I'm happy to see that, really. And I'm happy to see that I could push all the applications to the rum. So you will have only one installation. You can go ahead and install the Super Sous that comes with the rum, and then you're gonna be rooted. You could also alternatively install Magisk. I went for 16.7 because, in fact, yeah, I don't want the media manager, you know. I just want the root file and that's it. Then I'm done with that. So if I, yeah, in 18 must flash the root manager, and then it must go and get, and then I must still, you know, it's too much. I know it's better for the guys there at Magisk, you know, to have to see how many people are using their stuff, and you know, and get a better rating. But then you must build that in. Yeah, I don't know. Some things you cannot know. You cannot know everything. You know, every company these days want to know what we're doing and how much we're using that. I mean, that's not of their business what we're doing and how much we're using something to make things better. Make things better. You will hear the complaints. You know, you will read the complaints. You don't have to see the complaints. You don't have to look into people's devices to then make it better. That's how I see it. You know, I make my creations better every time, but I don't know how many people are using it. I don't have no statistics from that. It keeps me creative. You see? So in fact, I find it big nonsense that you know, apps and companies must know how we are using. Get the hell out of here. Why you want to know? Are you paying me to know? Am I working for you? Am I your slave? That's how I see it. That's exactly how I see it. I'm none of that. So get out of here. You don't have to know what I'm doing and how many times I'm using your application. You can already see. In Android world, you know, these app makers, they can see more than we want them to see. We read about applications in the Play Store, you know, that people, they had some trial on the thing or a test, I don't know. And then they did not end the test, they did not, you know. And then suddenly 200 and I don't know how much euros was taken away from their account. So that's why, you know, I don't do money business on my phone. Because this is the next thing that will happen, you know. So if you don't read the little lines and you did not unsubscribe, then suddenly your account has been, you know, credited and you just lost a couple of hundred euros. So then you contact Google and Google is telling you, yeah, but that's how it is. Sorry, we cannot help you. Then you had to read even better. So all sorts of little tricks people are putting in, you know, to let others, you know, pay. So this world, yeah, in fact, it's it's a crooked world, you know. And we see that the guys that we are supposed to trust, in fact, are the biggest scumbags. Yeah, the biggest scumbags, the things that they do. And the way how they treat users, how they abuse the rights of users. It's terrible. Terrible. And that's why the EU is coming with all sorts of rules, you know. And these fines would not be there if, you know, if everyone would just be nice to each other and would live good with each other, you know, and give the others what they deserve, you know, and not manipulate things with algorithms and crazy things like that. It's a wicked world that we're living in, man. This is Babylon system, really. Life in a Babylon ain't easy, you know? Really. Babylon system. Babylon system, my man. Haram. Whole lot of haram people in the world. And these are not the poor people or the people that don't have. No. These are those that we trust and that we love. These guys are haram. So here we go. Of course, this is you should go for the car launcher. You can go just once to see if it boots, if it's not giving any error. Allow car launcher to access. Yes. Access this device location if you want to. You know, I would say yes, allow. So then you get the right stations. Would you like car launcher to record audio? You can say no. Attention, during the operation of the vehicle, of use of the application may be unsafe. So be very careful when you use this application. And there we go. It's there it is, my man. You see that? Fully ready and in one go, good to do many things, because up here you're gonna find out that we have a whole lot of great apps installed. I'm gonna go through some of them. We have APK Pure, we have a ATC radio. Let me open that one for you, let me show you. Get crosswalk. You need crosswalk. That is an application that you will have to download. You can do that after you went onto the internet. And let me see. Always. Okay, the coolest of this launcher is that you can go ahead and find three different theme settings. There are a whole lot of settings that you can change. Here you have the various themes. You know, this one is nice, this one is nice, this one is also nice, this one's kind of classic. And then, is ROM porting safe? You ask me if it's safe. Nothing is safe, I just told you to accept. So there it is. So yeah, this is the other launcher, and up here, in fact, you have three models of the car launcher or boat or whatever you're gonna use this for. You can use this in the car, you can use it on your boat, you know. You could add some water maps to the system, waterkarte. You can do many things. It's just how you want to make it. And up here you're gonna say new folder, and you're just gonna call it apps. And you see there is no keyboard coming up, so you must go ahead and that is kind of strange. Let's see what that is. So why we have no keyboard? Cancel. So this is good that we're seeing this, then we can go ahead and fix this, huh? So let's just close this. No, close, go back, and then we're just gonna go to our settings. These we can find here, settings. And then we're gonna find our keyboard, language and input, curate keyboard, English. Oh, you see it was turned off. Go back, curate keyboard, you must turn it on. You see? So now we should have a keyboard. No? Okay. So let's see if now we get a keyboard, new folder. There you go, you see that? So you must enable the keyboard. If you don't enable the keyboard, you'll be like, hey, where is the keyboard? So you must watch this video good, eh? Otherwise you're gonna get crazy. You're gonna be like, hey, where is the keyboard? So then you create an app, folder app, and then you can just hit the folder and add any file that you wish to your shortcuts. This is really handy for the car. You know, if you're driving a car, this is the ham receiver, and here we have the scanner radio to listen to police ATC and so, and to, you know, this is a radio droid. This is a open source radio player that you can see as what is this application called? It's a very good. It's a world radio station. We have NPO, so we can watch live TV, etc. from the Netherlands and live radio. We have a cassette player. It's also very cool. This is kind of old school, you know. And up here you can change your cassettes and play music. You see, just like if you have a cassette player. So that's, I think, really nice. Yeah, so let me connect to the internet and let's see if this all works. Okay, we are connected to the internet. So let's start with the first application, the ham radio. Let's see if that one works. It seems to work. Oh, cancel. And there we are, let's turn it on. Could even go to the FM. Advices to select a little box. But this is a real radio with several bands, 30 meters or the 160 meters. USB, LSB, lower sideband, upper sideband, CW, AM, amplitude modulation, FM, frequency modulation. I only don't know what is CW. That was before my time. I'm not that old. In my time we had CB radio. So yeah, it's up to you to find the stations. Up here you can pull down and then you will see a graphic. This is the Netherlands, weird. We can set it. It's called weird, not word, but weird. W-E-E-R-T. And you will find out that at daytime, there is less to hear than at nighttime. It has to do with the QRM. All the noise in the air from all the machines that are running, they are making a whole lot of noise disturbances in the air. So this is for radio amateurs, okay? I'm not gonna bother you even longer with this application. Let's go to the next one. That one is the police scanner radio. This one is, my favorite. I love to listen to this at night most of the times when, you know, I take a shower or I go to bed. Then I like to listen to this. And for instance, Chicago police is one of my favorites. Sorry. But also, also live ATC, my pilot friends, you guys should go to here. For instance, you could go to, if you want to listen to the Netherlands, how you say that? If you want to listen to the Netherlands, You just go to browse by area. And then here you can see all the countries: Antigua, Barbuda, Argentina, Australia, Austria, Canada, Chile, Croatia, Czech Republic, France, Germany, Indonesia, Ireland, Luxembourg, Malaysia, Mexico, Netherlands, Peru, Philippines, Russian Federation, Slovenia, South Africa, Spain, Switzerland, Trinidad and Tobago, Ukraine, United Kingdom, and the United States are represented in here. So we're gonna go for the Netherlands. And then we just go to countrywide. And here you will find Maastricht. And this is a very busy airport from the Netherlands. It's also represented in X-Plane and in Flight Simulator X. And I do a whole lot of flights from Groningen, Eelde, that is as well in here, to Maastricht. Here you can add it to your favorites. At this moment there's no broadcast, but they will soon. Oh, it's still buffering. There it is. We're streaming now. And the frequencies are 121.5, 132.085, and 132.635, even 134.75, 135.975, and 136.465 megahertz. Unfortunately, AHAM is not in here. We don't have Schiphol, but we do have Groningen. This is Maastricht. Up here we have Airport Eelde, that is here in my city. You can also add it to your favorites. And it will be streaming in a couple of seconds. And this is as well very, very nice. And I don't know why I'm not charging. I should be. So yeah, that is also nice. Radio Droid, even nicer, will give you music and stations from all countries in the world. You can, well, not all countries, but a whole lot, okay? You see that? Even Suriname is in here. So my Suriname people can immediately listen to Radio Apinti. This is amazing. So I'm not gonna really play music, but here I can show you. In Suriname we have Garuda Radio and Radio Apinti. And nu at the grote lekbaka baya. As you can see, it plays fine, eh? It plays nice. It's not at this moment we have some applications open, we can close them like that. See that? Boom. Look at how many applications we had open. So this is the very best operating system effect for this device. Because, yeah, this is still an old device, eh, guys. Make no mistakes. This is an old device. Don't ever update this application called NPO. Otherwise, it will never work for you again. Ever. Okay? Because we have no Google services installed in here. You see that? Live TV, playing out of the box. Amazing, huh? So yeah, guys, what can I say? It's done, and it's out there for you as well now for the 7500, the 7510, and of course, the other device that is also supported. Congratulations. Now I can say that at least two of the Samsung 10.1 devices have their own, yeah, HAM International mod ROM, and that on a good operating system that is as well, you know, stable, and even though it's not fully updated, it's not the latest, but hey, I think to use this thing for your daily business, is it won't be possible. I think maybe you could, you know, by installing gaps onto 7.12, but then you're still dealing with a outdated operating system, and yeah, I don't know. I think if you still have this tablet and you want to enjoy a higher build of Android, then you must also give a destination to the device. You know, you should create something from it that you can just use forever. You know, it doesn't matter if it's updated or not updated. The moment you're gonna do banking and payments, and that's, you know, I don't do these things with computers. I go to the bank and talk to the guy that I see, you know, in front of me. I don't do nothing financial on computers, just because I don't like these systems. So yeah, if you have an old device like this, use it, give it a destination, let it be some TV player for you, or some ATC radio, or some radio that will play music from 100,000 stations that are broadcasting from off the internet. You know, use it in a way that the thing is still usable. Because let's be honest, some people, they say, yeah, but you can also install all these applications after you install them. I mean, of course you can do that. But if you're in the jungle, in the middle of nowhere, and you have no internet, then you cannot do that. Then you will have to go and look for internet, and certain ROMs are also demanding that you first connect to the internet before you can get past the screen. Like iPhones, for instance. Same crap. You know, with iPhones, you will always need an internet connection to activate the thing. But in fact, it's nonsense. You know, these devices, we should also be able to use it without activating them. Because maybe they are old, maybe you don't have no internet. So how are you gonna activate if you don't have all these things? So that's why I create, you know, devices that can live forever, you know, on whatever destination they got, just like that thing there at the back. It's eating dust at this moment, but this is in fact my TV player. If I'm in some room or place where I have no TV, and I just put the thing in the corner to let it play for me, and that's it. So it's fantastic. It's not like you know, I must do all sorts of things on it, and I must do banking and payments and put my social security number in there. Nothing like that. So if you want to do all these things, then you must go to the store and buy a new tablet. But if you want to use your old 10.1 tablet from 7.7 years ago in 2019, then you must think of a good destination for the device, what you're gonna do with it, and how you're gonna use it. And make sure not to demand too much from it. This, all that you see, even though it looks a whole lot, and even though it's very, very powerful as well as for navigation or for the boat, you know, just think of it. This is a device. Just think of any application that you would need to do your whatever you're doing, put it in there, and you know, you have a great device. And in fact, yeah, this is my car PC, that's how I call it, my car PC ROM. So yeah, now you guys on the 7510 and the 7500, I will have to go through these two other ROMs as well. Not sure if they gonna give me the same results, but you could test it. If you have these other devices, then you could test it. So let me know if you have the 7500 or the other one, not the 7510, because this ROM is for, and you know, it's only for the 7510. However, you know, if you go to the website of the guy, then you're gonna find the other versions as well. Download it, see if they work good on the tablet, let me know, you know, and then I will also make a mod. I will also mod these ROMs so you can install them in one go to the tablet, you know, or just go for my mod. I also have a mod if you're on Android 7.1.2. Just flash my Ham International mod on top of the ROM as secondly, then you're also gonna have that all. And it's really penetrating the ROM, eh? So that means if I'm gonna do a wipe data factory reset now on the tablet, it's gonna come just like this. It's not gonna come without, you know, I don't have to do anything else than just root the device again, and that's it. You know, I'll be good to go. All the applications will be there in one go. I don't have to go to any internet to get my radio player, my music player, and my whatever, you know, I want to do with the thing to get it going, because it's already pushed in. If you know other applications that you would love to see in this car radio, this Ham International, this CB radio mod, let me know. I would love to read that all in the comments. And then I want to thank you for watching this pretty long video again. And I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you like it. And I wish you all the best there with your beautiful Samsung 10.1 tablet from over 7 years old. And good luck with upgrading it. See you in the next video again. Until then, bye bye. Nice device. I like very much.